Hi Scorpio, welcome to your first May reading. Thank you so much for joining me here. Glad you guys are here with me. So this is going to be a general reading. We're going to look at like the general big picture, okay, for you, for an energy check-in. We're going to do more focused, like love focused on the extended reading. So if you want to look more into love, then you can access the extended reading through my Patreon or a one-time purchase. I have a limited number of memberships left on in the tiers that I have on Patreon right now. I have it all written out in the description box. So if you want to get in where I have the membership levels now and the perks that I have them now, that's all going to be gone very soon. Those are selling out quick. Okay, so check all that out. Let's see. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. If it doesn't resonate for you, check your other placements. Check your previous Scorpio readings. Doesn't matter what month they were in. They're all really timeless. Okay. It's all like, time is fluid in tarot. So what I spoke about 3 months ago, what could absolutely be, relevant now. Okay. Please thumbs up the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I would super appreciate that. Leave me a comment. Oh, I forgot to mention too, my Patreon has a level, $7.77 level. And when you sign up at that level, you get a free 30-minute reading. Okay, you also get a 5 to 10 minute reading every month and access to all the extendeds. So I only have one more spot in that level. Okay, so maybe it might be gone by this time, this video releases, but check to see, and I'm listing out what is left, okay? All right, Scorpio, let's get your overall energy. Whoa, that came out fast. To the sea, okay? So very watery energy like you. To the sea, which is about going with the flow, okay? Going with the flow of the universe, letting things go the way that they need to. Spirit leading you, okay? She's looking down in her boat and letting spirit lead her and not having to like focus on the water and try to control the boat ride. We have time to go in the reverse. So I feel like there's something you might want to walk away from, but I'm going to look more into that card as well before I say anything. But I mean, the time to go is usually about time to go. It's time to walk away from something and leave something behind. It's in the reverse, so it may not be time to walk away from whatever it is quite yet. Okay, maybe it's a job, maybe it's a friendship. I feel like, you know, if it's a toxic friendship or relationship or something, I feel like, you know, no better time is the present time, okay, like in those situations. But yeah, we'll look more into that situation, okay? Yeah, with the TikTok in reverse, it's almost like there's something here that needs more time, okay? And allowing the universe to take the lead here is kind of what I'm seeing. Something needs more time. We have yin, yeah, for sure. Okay, so the yin is all about, you know, the feminine, divine feminine energy. It's about receiving, allowing that spiritual energy of I'm just going to trust the universe for what I need and what I want. Okay, so for some of you, this could be, you know, walking away from a job or something like that. For some of you, I feel like you're wondering how you're going to move from one segment of your life to the next. And you're really like wondering how am I going to get from point A to point B, because I really don't want to be at point A anymore. I really want to be at this time of my life and I want to be at a better time. You're not seeing how it's all going to work out, but I feel like spirit is saying trust. Okay. When it's time to move on, you will move on. The universe will move you on. Close the doors that are necessary to close and open the doors that are necessary to open. We have orphaned in the reverse with mending in the reverse. This is a time for a lot of you to be healing from like abandonment wounds and things like that. healing from a broken relationship. So if you're in a place where you're healing from a broken relationship, maybe it's not time to move on from that yet. You're still in that place of healing. You're still in that place of mending your heart. And you're trying to kind of come out of that, you know, quicker than you want to. It's like, I don't want to be in this pain anymore. I don't want to be in this, you know, growth period anymore. I want out of this. But it may not be time to walk away from that yet. It may be time to, you know, continue to sit with those feelings and like allow yourself to heal. We have two, all that glitters in the reverse. Interesting. Okay. That all that glitters is about like, sometimes it's about wearing a mask and like not being who your true authentic self. It can be about somebody else not being their true authentic self around you. Okay. I feel like you guys are learning how to, be your true authentic self through this time of healing, through this time of growth here. So we'll get some more energy on that and see what that's about. Tell me about all that glitters. Peace in reverse. Okay. Deep knowing. So there could be something here where, you know, you have a deep knowing about somebody or something. It's like you see behind the veil, you see beyond the veil, and it really kind of gives you some anxiety when you think about it. But there's something here that's like needs to be looked at a little bit more than it has been. Okay. All right. Let's look at the, Moonology. What happened here? Oh, I put them back the wrong way. Okay. Oh, goodness gracious. All right. Moonology. What does the moon want to say to Scorpio spirit? We just had the full moon in Scorpio, so I wonder, I'm just, you know, thinking that a lot of this had to do with what happened during that full moon, you know, the pain that came up, like the wounds that came up, the things that came up to the surface during that full moon, having some anxiety come out. I know for me, I was extremely anxious the day of the full moon. And then the couple days after the full moon, I was dead tired. It was almost like spirit was doing this inner work on me through the moon. And, you know, I was just out of it. So I'm guessing I have a lot of Scorpio placements. So I'm guessing, you know, for you guys as Scorpios or people, you guys with Scorpio placements went through kind of probably a rough time as well. Okay. Let's look at this here. We have emotions are running high. Super moon. That's what we just had. The super moon was in Scorpio. It was the pink moon. Okay. So super moon, the emotions are running high. I feel like you're going through a very emotional time, okay? Especially with that first card coming out, the Two of the Sea. It just reminds me of water and emotions. Okay, we have the energy is gaining momentum. So we have energy, emotions are running high, and the energy is gaining momentum. So there's a lot of really strong energy right now, and it's probably a little bit hard to deal with, okay? Oh, look at that. It's time to release negativity. Full moon in Scorpio. Look at that. That's what I was just talking about. Okay. So the full moon in Scorpio, I think, had a big impact on you, whether you knew it or not. Think about how you've been feeling the last few days and what's been going on with you and the emotions that have been rising up in you. I feel like that's what this is all dealing with. Allowing the universe and like spirit to do that work within you. It's time to release negativity. There are things to start releasing, okay? Whether it's negative situations, negative people, negative feelings, all of that, okay? Any other cards for Scorpio? Lots of people have been getting the full moon in Scorpio card, by the way. So I feel like, you know, lots of people were affected by this last full moon in a big way. Any other cards for Scorpio, please? Okay. Let's grab a couple of these cards. What is going on for Scorpio? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Okay, we have guilt. All right. It's time to release negativity, and then we have guilt come out. So you guys could be healing and mending from guilt from the past. Okay. There could be a lot of, I release any beliefs that no longer assist my soul's growth, it says. Okay. What else for Scorpio? We have denial. I acknowledge my fear, but I replace it with the insight of awareness. Okay. We have relationships. I am attracted to those people who serve my highest good. And we have purpose. I know what I am here to do. Okay. So this is about releasing negativity. This is about releasing guilt. This is about coming out of denial with this All That Glitters card. Okay. This is coming out of denial, coming out of a place of wearing a mask, coming out of a place of like needing to control these situations and control everything that's going on within you, and dealing with relationships, either past wounds from relationships or dealing with the relationships that are in your life right now, and understanding that you have a purpose, okay? And there's a purpose to all of this, and it's not just for nothing, all right? Whatever situations that you're dealing with right now and the emotions that are coming up from that are all coming up for a reason. Any other cards for Scorpio? Empathy. Okay. Empathy. I'm seeing, and we have change under that. All right. So I understand that nothing can grow or evolve without movement. So there's big changes coming for you guys, I feel. The last few readings for you guys, the last few months have been really, really heavy on a big change coming for you guys. Okay. We have empathy. I'm open to seeing both sides of a situation. So maybe you need empathy right now when it comes to a relationship or even just yourself. Okay. So, using that empathy for whatever it is you need at the time. Okay. What is going on? Let's get to the tarot. What is going on for Scorpio, Holy Spirit? Wow. Exactly. Oh my gosh. Look at this, you guys. Change, big change is on the horizon. Okay, we have the World card. This is, especially with the Three of Wands here, there's a lot that you have been looking forward to, that you've been manifesting, that you've been wanting, and it's literally right on the horizon. With this Three of Wands, you're about to close out a big chapter in your life. You're about to, okay? I feel like you're still dealing with some karmic situations. You're still dealing with some emotions from past situations and things like that. But I feel like you finally have made a decision to step into your like independence, step into your abundance. You finally made a decision. Like, I feel like a lot of you know the direction you want to go in your life, or you're starting to really figure it out. Okay. And if you haven't, I see you finding your direction very, very soon. All right. Tell me about the World. Spirit, tell me about the World. Wow, Ace of Pentacles, Ten of Wands. Oh my goodness, Five of Swords in the reverse, Five of Wands. Okay, so the fives represent like a turning point. So you guys are dealing with, you're letting go of the need to control everything. I feel like you're going to be releasing a dramatic situation, dropping the burdens and the baggage from past situations, okay, with this Ten of Wands. This is the end of a chapter as well. This is releasing burdens and baggage from the past and moving on to a new chapter. The Tens represent the end of a chapter or the fulfillment of a chapter. You're moving on. Ace of Pentacles, you have a brand new beginning coming towards you. You have a new start and a new opportunity coming towards you, okay? With these ten and the World. Tell me more about this Ace of Pentacles, please, Spirit. Tell me more about this Ace of Pentacles. Okay, we have the Wheel. Tell me more about this Ace of Pentacles, please, Spirit. Okay, we have the Ace of Swords, Seven of Swords in reverse, Knight of Swords, and the Page of Cups. Wow. Okay, I feel like there, for some of you, okay, you're closing out a karmic cycle here with this Wheel in reverse. So this is about, like, remember I said it might not be time to move on from something, and there's just a timing thing involved in allowing this you know, the universe to and spirit to really work its magic. You're closing out some kind of chapter, okay, and dealing with some kind of karmic lesson here. Once you're done with that karmic lesson, this is going to go into the upright position, and your luck is about to change, okay? Something is about to turn around for you. I see somebody gaining clarity here. Could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, or could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Somebody who's run from you in the past or has been running from this connection, somebody's about to gain clarity. And I feel like there's going to be some kind of apology or somebody coming towards you wanting to speak some type of message of love to you or apology. Okay. And I feel like it's going to be some kind of really quick change coming towards you. Somebody who has run away from you in the past with the Seven of Swords, somebody who's denied this connection, and with this Ace of Swords, somebody who's gained clarity and finally sees the light. Okay. The Seven of Swords can be like self-deception, but it's in the reverse. It's like they're seeing the light now. Ace of Swords, somebody is seeing the light. And I say this is somebody because we have so many court cards. We have the Knight of Swords and the Page of Cups. So this usually represents people, okay? I see somebody changing their tune, seeing something clearly and coming towards you, all right? So we're going to move into the extended reading, and we're going to look. I see. Oh, you ate it. Good job. We're going to move into the extended reading. We're going to look more into the situation for you and then see who this person is coming towards you or what the situation is. And I'm guessing it's a love situation, okay? So we're going to look at that in the extended reading. You can do Patreon or the one-time purchase to get there. Hope that I see you guys there, and I will see you later, okay? Bye, Scorpio. There's something here about them not feeling like totally stable, okay? And with this King of Wands, they have a lot of fire energy and air, definitely a lot of water energy too, and a lot of earth, okay? But the earth energy and the water energy is in the reverse. We have the King of Wands out, so they could be a fire sign, Sagittarius, Leo, Aries, okay? But I feel like this person is very passionate, wants to take control of the situation, is a leader, okay? Very creative and yeah, very passionate person, okay? Let's look at this Pentacles situation. Why is the Queen of Pentacles in reverse? Wow, King of Pentacles in reverse with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Oh, this is crazy. Okay.